Hi, you're watching Editor's Take. I'm Priyanka Sahay, and I have with me Gaurav Choudhary, Deputy Executive Editor of Moneycontrol with us. Hi, Gaurav. Thank you so much for being there with us today. Now, what has happened is that the Cabinet has approved an amendment in the Aadhaar Act. Now, Gaurav, I would like to understand from you as to how will this impact, or, you know, what does this mean exactly for the end consumers?
So there are two things. One, this should be seen in the light of what the Supreme Court has said about the Aadhaar Act in October. If you recall, the Supreme Court had struck down a certain section of the Aadhaar Act,
Right. Saying
that private companies cannot access, cannot force people to share their Aadhaar details.
Right.
And this had created a lot of problems for the banks and telecom companies, financial services companies and telecom companies, because they were, before the Supreme Court decision ruling came, that they were using, they were forcing people to use their, asking people to use their Aadhaar, give their Aadhaar details for carrying out what is called the e-KYC or electronic know your customer
Right. Norms.
And that had brought in its own, system of efficiencies and speed according to these companies.
Yes.
But after the Supreme Court said that private companies cannot use people's Aadhaar details for carrying out these kind of activities, they were in a bit of a quandary. They wanted, according to them, by going back to the usual, the offline physical verification system, it's going to add to the costs and is also going to add to a lot of time. So they were trying to find out a way out, and they had met the government and also had been arguing with the government that there has to be some system of using biometric authentication of people to bring in efficiencies and also reduce cost. To this effect, the government did respond to that concern, and before the elections actually took place, the previous government, which demitted office in May, actually had brought about an ordinance. And that ordinance could not pass because the Lok Sabha got dissolved, and now we have a new Lok Sabha and a new government, and the Modi government has come back to power with a bigger majority. The Aadhaar laws, the amendments that the government has proposed, essentially will allow customers to disclose their Aadhaar details voluntarily if fintech companies or financial service services companies or telecom companies actually want to use those. Telecom companies and this class of companies, fintech and banking companies, say that onboarding customers becomes a very costly affair in the conventional physical verification
Right. System.
And also physical verification takes a longer time. So this is going to help their cause tremendously.
Absolutely. And, you know, I will come back to the voluntary submission of the documents a little later. But first, let me ask you, at this point in time, and with the data that you have, we get to understand that rupees 15 is approximately what most of these companies used to incur when they were doing e-KYC, as compared to rupees 100, which is the actual cost of doing a physical e-KYC. Now, don't you think that such a move will actually have a huge impact on the financials of the company as well?
More than that, the cost difference in onboarding new customers, customer acquisition is something that is a very, very important part of the operations of these companies.
Absolutely.
Both fintech and telecom companies. So onboarding new customers, the cost of onboarding a new customer will probably come down from about 100 for if you use the conventional physical KYC system to an e-KYC system to 15 rupees in an e-KYC,
right.
And that's a significant drop in cost. And also in the conventional system, it would have taken about 7 days to.
Right.
Sometimes it takes up to 7 days to verify a customer's credentials. In an e-KYC system, it just takes about 15 to 30 minutes.
Absolutely.
And that brings in a lot of efficiency. So those who want to voluntarily disclose their Aadhaar details, they'll be allowed. Once, obviously, the necessary assumption in all of this is that the parliament should first vote these amendments and the new bill into law, and these amendments need to be notified. Only then that process will start. But once the cabinet has approved these amendments, it will eventually go through the usual parliamentary process, and by, say, 3 to 6 months, or if the government is unable to pass it in the current Lok Sabha the next Lok Sabha session, which will run from June to July, then probably in the session after that, it should be passed. The government is hopeful that it should be passed in the current session, in the next session itself. If all of this fall in place and go according to plan, then fintech companies and telecom companies will probably go back to the previous e-KYC system regardless of whether the Supreme Court has struck down the order or not, because they expect that most customers will voluntarily disclose the Aadhaar details.
Right. Coming back to the voluntary part of our discussion, now, do we at all see that this could be a potential grey area? Because at the end of the day, there are customers in the tier 2 cities and smaller cities who perhaps would not be knowing what voluntary disclosure of these documents are. So do you think that there will be a chance wherein a couple of these companies will be able to exploit this voluntary disclosure of documents?
Yeah, so the question here is whether to what extent fintech companies are going to force them.
Right.
Fintech or telecom companies are going to force them. If the companies are not going to force them, it's well within the people's right not to disclose them.
Right.
The only thing is that this class of companies there should not be any evidence of them trying to force people to disclose the Aadhaar details. That will go against what the Supreme Court has said, and also what this new law, once it is legislated, will say, because the voluntary is the key word here.
Yes.
If it is not voluntary, it is up to the customer's right whether to disclose or not disclose. So if it is not voluntary, the companies cannot force the customer to disclose.
Right.
Only in the case the customer is willing to disclose can the companies use this in e-KYC system. If there is any violation, clearly the onus will be on the companies to show that they did not force people to disclose the other details under any kind of duress.
All right, well then, so voluntary disclosure will be the key word here, and we will have to wait to see as to how this shapes up in the near future. Now, thanks for watching. Stay tuned to Money Control for more news and updates. Thanks for watching.